Operation turn my truck into a grandpa mobile has been completed. You can see here on my 95 Suburban, I now have a unibrow as well as some window deflectors on all the windows, on the doors, of course. And personally, being an older body style like this, that square body style, I kind of feel like this looks really good. So what do you guys think? How does this look? Comment below and let me know. So yeah, I've been wanting to get some window deflectors for all the doors. So when I go overlanding, I can crack the windows, still have rain and snow protection, but still be able to get some adequate airflow out of the vehicle and in the vehicle. And so I went on the search for the best style, the best type of window deflectors. And of course, because I really think WeatherTech makes pretty dang good products, I currently have their all-weather laser-cut floor mats in my truck. I searched their site, and they did. They had a set of these window deflectors, as well as this unibrow here you can see. And actually, when I first bought this truck, it did have a bug deflector on the front hood. I actually liked the way that looked a lot, but the one that was on there looked like it had been on there forever, so I took it off. But I've secretly been wanting to get another one for a long time, so I figured since I was getting the window deflectors, why not go back to that bug deflector on the front also? And so with that, I think this total package looks really good. It fits the truck really well. That's in my opinion, of course. Let me know if you think differently. So here's this front WeatherTech bug deflector. They do have their logo here, which I believe this is just a sticker. I could take this off if I want, but I think I'm just gonna leave it on there for now. We'll see how long that lasts. And it is like a tinted see-through material. It seems to be very high quality. I'm really happy with the quality and the feel of this. And looking at it from the front here, you can really get a sense for just how good this thing looks. I don't know, guys. Something about the way these trucks are designed, I think it fits these unibrow bug deflectors really well. Now, one thing I do want to note here is this thing wasn't perfect out of the box. For some reason, this passenger side corner was not angled the way you see it now. It was kind of almost really straight. And you can see on this driver's side just how angled this is and how well it fits the body lines of the truck. And this one was actually very straight. So I had to take my heat gun and very gently persuade it to kind of go along with the body lines of the truck. It's still not perfect, but then again, I'm not expecting it to be perfect. It's definitely good enough. We'll take a look a little bit at how this thing is attached. You can see right here, I marked the center line of the hood, and they do have kind of a little divot there marking the center line of this unibrow. It did come with screws, and there are holes pre-drilled for screws, but this thing does come with double-sided tape already attached to the inside of this lip here. And if I can get away with not having to screw extra screw holes into anything on my truck, I'm gonna do that. So we'll see how long this lasts. You can see the holes here from the previous bug deflector that was installed, but this one isn't quite the same. So the double-sided tape seems to be doing the trick really well. And here we'll take a look at the profile on this passenger side I was talking about. I had to make it curve like this because it was pretty straight. And here is the driver's side. And yeah, you can see it's pretty close. You're not gonna really notice that one side is a little bit different from the other. And so for me, it's good enough. Yes, it is attached very tight. I cannot anticipate this coming off really ever unless I wanted it to. And even then, it would probably be extremely difficult to get this thing off. Another note is I did have to raise this latching system up just a hair to compensate for the thickness of this material. Onto the window deflectors and what I originally set out to accomplish here. I wanted these in-channel window deflectors. And I do know you can buy a style that pretty much double-sided tapes itself to the top here, but I definitely didn't want that if I could get away with having the in-channel deflector. And that's exactly what WeatherTech sells. So you can see with this in-channel deflector, there's actually a chamfered edge that is shaved down really, really thin, actually razor thin. It's really sharp. I cut myself pretty bad on it. And that chamfered edge fits inside the window channel exactly where your window would rest. So you can imagine just what a tight fit it is, because basically what you're doing with this deflector is taking up extra space in that window channel. This thing literally sits on the outside of where that window would be rolling up. And one thing to note here, on some vehicles, this deflector is completely 100% in channel. But because of the design of the windows on this door, you have to use this metal S-clip that they provide. And what you do is pull down the weather stripping. The S-clip kind of clips onto the metal part of your door. You push all the weather stripping back in, and the very end of this deflector slides into that S-clip. And let me tell you, it is an extremely tight fit. And moving on to the back door here, you can see that there is an S-clip not only on the front, but another version here on the rear of this door. But same concept here for the rear doors. It is in channel for most of it, so it's in channel all the way around until you get to the end here. There's just no channel for this part of the deflector to slide into, and so that's why you have to use these S-clips. But overall, I have to say I really, really like the look of these things, and of course the functionality is what I originally intended for, which was being able to crack my window, have airflow, yet still have protection from the elements. And looking at it from the inside here, you can see that these are tinted as well. And you can see it goes all the way down to the bottom of the window, and it does not block my view to my side view mirrors at all. And there's what the passenger side looks like. And even on that side, it's not blocking my side view mirror visibility at all. And here you can see just what that front bug deflector looks like. I don't know what it is, man. Something about just the square body with these extra kind of plasticky curved panels on it. I don't know what it is. I think it just really looks and works really good with this style of a vehicle. I have to say though, the install process didn't go as easily as I would have hoped. They were actually fairly difficult to get into that channel and to get the window to roll all the way up. They say in the instructions that you're supposed to get that window to roll up and down 5 times, and that'll somewhat set that deflector into the channel. In my case, however, that didn't work. I had to actually grab the window on both sides with my hands and use pressure to push the window up into the channel while at the same time hitting the switch every so often just to get that window fully seated in there. And then after that, with the windows fully seated, you're supposed to let it sit for over 24 hours. And I believe what that's doing is just stretching out all that rubber in that window channel so that everything kind of fits together. Not gonna lie, there are a couple things about this I don't like. I don't like these S-clips. I wish they provided some kind of tape, and now that I'm thinking about it, I wish there was something to protect the body panel on the door from the metal of these S-clips. Because I'm wondering if over time, every time I roll down and up my window, is that going to move the S-clips ever so slightly, causing the paint to rub off? I don't know, maybe that won't happen, but it seems like it could. I also wanna note that these things are actually made in Germany. It says so on the sticker right here. And they do seem like they're a very high quality material, and that chamfered edge seems like it was done really well. They are definitely an extremely tight fit. But actually, I'd rather it be a tight fit than just kind of loosey-goosey. So other than the kind of difficult install process, I feel like this was a good purchase. It's going to allow me to roll my windows down when it's raining or snowing out and not get weather inside on my door panel in my switch areas. And I think that's very important. For example, if I'm out truck camping and I'm sleeping in the back inside my truck and I'm using the Mr. Buddy heater, I definitely would rather have a window cracked. But if it's raining or snowing outside, then having a window cracked is going to let in that rain and snow. And all that water does have the potential to damage things, especially if it gets down into the window switches and stuff like that. So as far as functionality goes, I think these are spot on. I am kind of curious about this area right here where it comes out from the window channel and just kind of sits in this S-clip. This to me seems like a potential area that water could get through, but it is very small and it is very tight up against this, so maybe not. Also on the rear window version here, I'm wondering why they just left this corner so sharp. I feel like they could have rounded that off just to make it look a little better. And you can see here how that fits inside this channel, but this channel definitely is bulging right now, and that's because I have these windows all the way up as tight as they'll go. You can definitely see that bulge right here, and I'm a little curious if this is going to somehow damage this rubber. Like if, for example, for some reason I wanted to take these out, is this rubber going to be forever loose now? But as long as they fit and look like this, I'll probably end up keeping these on the truck because I really like the way it looks. So with that being said, guys, what do you think? Comment below and let me know your thoughts. Maybe you have another brand or another system that works better than this. Let me know. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget that thumbs up, and also consider subscribing if you're not already. Also check that description below for links and other information. But for One Road, I'm Jimmy, and I will see you in the next one.